Good morning and welcome. We are so excited and thankful that you are here today to stand with us on behalf of individuals with disabilities. As many of you know, my passion for disabilities is driven by our personal family experience with our seventh child, Rebecca, who died 8 years ago of complications of Prader-Willi syndrome. And during that year of having Rebecca with us, it was the hardest year of our lives, but as my son that just returned from Afghanistan defending our country said, it was also the best year of our lives. We were in and out of ICU, in and out of special care clinics, sat monitors, oxygen, all kinds of care and special needs that really went across the board 24 hours a day. But during that time, it showed me from a little bit of personal experience the challenges that families of children with disabilities experience familially, socially, financially, emotionally, and in every other way. And in Missouri, we have an extraordinarily high population of individuals with either physical or developmental disabilities. And that percentage in Missouri by population is nearly 30%. And in recent years, as you know, the Missouri House of Representatives and the Senate have moved some groundbreaking legislation, including the Missouri Autism Projects and Autism Insurance Reform, which we passed last year and was signed into law by Governor Nixon. I've now just begun my fifth year in the House of Representatives, and I cannot tell you how energized and excited I am to have the privilege and opportunity to chair the new Special Standing Committee on Disability Services in the House of Representatives. And all of us owe a deep debt of gratitude to Speaker Stephen Tilley for having the leadership and the foresight to make this a top priority and create this committee. And I ask you, whether in person or by his office or by email or phone, please communicate to Speaker Tilley your thankfulness for making this important decision on January 25th of this year. As Speaker Tilley alluded to, we have about 12 bills that are moving through committee right now, and we're just getting started. We've had two hearings now in an executive session. We've heard probably six bills. We've got 12 disability-related bills in the pipeline. As Speaker Tilley mentioned, we've got the Disability History and Awareness Month that we're seeking to establish in Missouri K-12 schools that will bring advocacy and awareness and appreciation for the history of disabilities in Missouri and our nation, and especially instilling in young students an appreciation and a respect and a sensitivity for their fellow students with disabilities. And we believe this will bring a tremendous limitation and downturn in the incidences of bullying against children and students with disabilities. We've got mental health first aid. We've got a bill that's going to put on the Mo Health Net Oversight Committee a mental health practitioner. We've got comprehensive day rehab for victims of traumatic brain injury. The Departments of Health and Senior Services, along with the Department of Social Services and Mo Health Net, are working on a TBI, traumatic brain injury, waiver that will be to expand services for those folks with brain injuries. And we have a waiting list now that we want to see that reduced. One of the greatest innovations we've had in recent months and years is the Partnership for Hope waiver, a partnership between the state of Missouri and the county boards for developmental disabilities that's now seen almost 500 people taken off the disabilities waiting list and they're receiving services. We're going to have another, thank you, it's a great development. We're going to have another 400 or 500 more hopefully within the next year, put on the partnership for hope waiver and remove from the waiting list. We've got legislation to remove forever from all Missouri statute any reference to mental retardation. We believe that all Missourians, regardless of disability, need to be respected, protected, and appreciated, honored, and valued. We've got legislation moving that is going to develop a tax checkoff to where Missourians will have an opportunity when they return and file their state income tax to make a donation to reduce the developmental disabilities waiting list. And as Steve Tilley mentioned, one of the most important pieces of legislation that we're moving right now is parental rights for individuals with disabilities. And many of you know that there was a blind couple, a young couple, last summer that had their newborn baby removed from the home without explanation for 57 days. And then return to the home, again, without explanation. And we want to make sure that the rights of parents with disabilities are not infringed upon by the state. And we've got a lot more that's going to be moving through this committee, but the thing that I was so excited about when Speaker Tilley formed this committee on January 25th, he said, "Jeff, we're going to refer a lot of legislation to you, and I want you to move these bills to the floor so we can get them passed." But he also said, more importantly, that I want your committee to drive good policy related to folks with physical and developmental disabilities that is responsive to the disabilities community. And I would say that one of my greatest priorities and goals of my remaining 4 years in the House of Representatives is to see a reduction, if not an elimination, of the developmental disabilities wait list. I believe that individuals with disabilities should be among those that receive the first portions of government funding. And instead, they often have to fight for the crumbs off the table. And we are here to fight for you, to advocate for you, and we are going to change that. It has been the honor of my life to represent in the House of Representatives and General Assembly so many individuals and families and groups and organizations that advocate for those with disabilities. And I want to especially thank those of you who have taken the high road to realize that as we advocate, we need to be peaceful, positive, and proactive, and look to the legislators as our partners and offer to be a resource for them versus some of the past practices of extreme protest, antagonism, and being combative. It is so important that we maintain a professional and a positive message. And I always like to use the reference of one of my favorite lobbyists here in the building. You know, lobbyists get a bad name, but there are some lobbyists that represent their industry with knowledge and excellence. And one of the best ones we've got in the building is a young man named Sean with Paraquad in St. Louis. Sean is bound by a wheelchair, but he is a tremendous advocate. He is tireless. Day and night here in the Capitol, we see him in the halls. We see him visiting members' offices, and we see him in the hearings. And he is always professionally dressed as well, suit and tie. And you know, it's interesting that when we are required by House and Senate rules to wear a suit and tie, it's refreshing to have somebody come to us that is contextual to where how we have to be. And so I encourage you, in your approach with legislators, continue to be professional, continue to be respectful, continue to be positive, peaceful, and proactive in your message, and we will do tremendous things to move Missouri forward and see Missouri become the leader in the nation for disabilities advocacy and innovations. And I want to thank you for the privilege to address you today and thank you for being here. But I want to right now introduce a special friend who has been a tremendous advocate for the elderly in Missouri. He has been a champion for children. He has been a defender and a voice for individuals with disabilities. Please give a warm welcome to Lieutenant Governor Peter Kinder.